getting into the program, I'm like, well, wait a minute, what was I thinking about? You know, you do have it, and it unlocked all of that mental drive that I have, that I've always had. Now I'm just super hungry to learn as much as I can.
So justice through code is especially for people who have had justice involvement. So you don't have to feel uncomfortable. You don't have to feel like, you know, you're hiding something. Everyone's in the same boat. So they work with you on those issues, and they coach you on how to join job interviews and how to talk about that. And that's important. Once you have that confidence and you have that skill, you can make a contribution to society. It makes you not want to return to the life that you were living. It makes you want to move forward.
Formerly incarcerated people or currently incarcerated people, where they face such a stigma when it comes to getting back into the workforce. And that, I think, becomes internal as well, right? So if you can, from within, make someone really believe that, like, yeah, I can learn this thing, that I don't actually have this limiting belief, you could totally transform someone's life. And it's sort of like giving someone superpowers.
There were times where I felt as though that I'm just basically trapped, that this is my lot, there's no way out. I'm just gonna be a nobody for the rest of my life. I'm not gonna be able to do anything that's really gonna matter to anybody.
While I was incarcerated, there was just this constant messaging by the system that when you got home, or when we got home, the best that we could hope for was a minimum wage job. And so getting people into really stable jobs where they have benefits, where they can provide for themselves and their families, was something that seemed of great importance to me.
I really enjoy learning. So I'll stay up till 3 o'clock in the morning working on these problems, and I'll be happy to do it. Like, I love the problem solving. I finally get it, I'm finally learning it, and I finally can be a part of it, and it's a great feeling.
It's been incredibly rewarding to see how invested some of the large corporations that we're working with, and Columbia MBA students and different professors at Columbia are in really working to solve the problem of mass incarceration.
We have the opportunity here at the school to provide that bridge between, you know, companies that need really high quality talent and people who are desperate for jobs and really want to prove themselves and prove that they can do this. And all that we're doing is, you know, enabling faculties and providing the resources to be able to create that bridge.
I don't know if you're familiar with the book Les Miserables. That's my favorite book in the whole world, because it was about Jean Valjean, the person. He's a person, but he's judged for having a criminal record. And thus, I think that code can help me be that person, that Jean Valjean, who one day, I might not be able to get all my dreams, but I'll still be able to make 100K, feed my family, and maybe inspire other people, teach others, go back into the prison, go back into maybe the schools and give coding courses.
I definitely feel like this is a great thing for my daughter to witness. She's gonna grow up seeing me working at a big company, me working hard, and I really hope that that will teach her to do the same, to put the work in, to put the effort in, and that she'll be able to accomplish and be anything that she wants, and that's what I really want for her.